Hi Gemini, welcome to Miraculous Tribe guys. This is going to be for Gemini Sun Moon Rising for the month of November 2018. Guys, my name is Ayushi and not all the messages are going to resonate with you because it's a general reading. So keep that in mind, as well as use your own intuition. Apply this reading to your situation according to your own intuition, and if it doesn't resonate, then it might not have been meant for you. So let's see what's coming up for Gemini Sun Moon Rising. Okay, the Moon card is coming out as a flipper along with the Five of Cups. There is some disappointment that some of you are facing when it comes to a emotional investment. So you feel that something that you had invested in a lot, where you have given yourself a lot, and you were emotionally quite connected with something, that thing has not worked out. It has broken into pieces. You feel very emotionally all over the place, if I can say that. You don't know where which paths to take, where to go from here. Navigation has become difficult because of this emotional loss that you're facing. You're in fact feeling that it's better that I leave this situation because I know something better is waiting for me. So you are having that sort of thought, but the problem is that you feel that somebody has tricked you, and when you feel that somebody has tricked you, half of your heart is not able to process that, and you are giving it some it is quite painful considering the fact that you were emotionally involved in this situation. But what I'm getting here is that this was fated, whatever the situation is, this was fated. And I'm getting that you need to trust your intuition regarding the situation, and things are going to clear out with due time. They are not going to clear out right now. If you are looking for some answers, why this has happened, why me, or anything of that nature, those answers are not going to come to you right now. So give it some time before the things can clear up. So don't stay stuck in a situation which is not serving you for now. So it could have been that this was a situation where you were emotionally selfless, or you were dealing with a water sign, Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer. It can be Sun Moon Rising. So Gemini, Son of Pentacles, Two of Swords, Eight of Wands, Three of Swords, Daughter of Cups, Six of Swords, Nine of Pentacles, Mother of Wands, Mother of Cups, and Father of Swords. So a lot of people here in this reading, and we have Justice as the bottom of the deck and overall energy. So when we have a lot of court cards in the reading, it's definitely that it can be a three-party situation, considering in past we have Three of Swords. So definitely there could have been a three-party situation for some of you. Okay, for some of you, I'm also getting the message here that some of you have recently become single, or you were always wanted to be single, or you are happily single now. So this is your single card. You are coming up in your reading as single, or you are enjoying your company, or your whatever that you have made up till now, you are enjoying it. I'm also getting here that there is some messages back and forth that are being shared between you and somebody else. There is someone who can also be traveling. It can be solo travel, like the person is traveling alone. It can be not a literal journey. It can be someone who is in a relationship, but they are the only person in the relationship who is actually there. It can be that, and it can also be that a person is on a journey just by themselves. It can be any sort of journey. It doesn't have to be a traveling or anything. It could be life journey or something like that. So I'm getting that someone has been single for a really long time. Now what I'm also getting here is that someone is being very stubborn and very focused on their own idea, how they work and how they want to go. So they might be in a very my way or the highway space. They are not able to it can be you that who is trying to offer somebody something like a help or some money. At the same time, you are being obstructed by the fact that you are in a conflict, like you're not able to decide there is some decision that you're not able to decide on. It could be related to, should I invest in this or not? Should I offer this person this thing or not? It could be money and help or something like that, or a physical support, something like that. So there will be some communication regarding this, or you want to communicate about this, or you want some movement in your life regarding this. Now, movement, when I say that, it means that there are things that are stuck right now and you want that it should shift, the energy should shift. So you are waiting for that. I'm also getting that there is somebody who is emotionally very expressive and comforting. So there is some emotional comfort, but not a commitment. Like maybe you need a emotional comfort, but nothing more than that. Like, you don't want some heavy burden or responsibility. You just want emotional outlet. So you want to share a lot with somebody, or someone around you is like this, who wants to share their emotions and talk about their emotions or what they have faced in their past, what the hardships that the trauma that they have dealt with. They want to communicate about that trauma, and through that they want to move forward, because before they can actually move forward mentally, they want to move forward by, basically I'm getting speech therapy or talk therapy. So they need somebody to listen to. Something of that nature is coming up here. This card is very prominent, so somebody is either very comfortable being single, or they don't want to be single anymore, something of that nature. But I'm getting that someone around you is very like either a motherly figure, or this person, whoever around you this person is, they are very protective about something they're trying to protect with their entire being. Basically they are not willing to share, or they are not willing to let anyone in on something that they feel is very precious to them. So they are very fiercely protecting something. They can also be a very confident and bold person, and your fear or your hopes is that this person or someone around you or you should share something emotional. I'm getting that you don't want to be emotional, or you are wanting somebody else to be emotional. You are fearing that someone should not become emotionally clingy, or you are fearing that you will become emotionally clingy. Something of that nature is coming up. Now what's the outcome here is that Gemini, this is a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising card. So the outcome here is that something very formal, something logical, something really cold will be said, or you will become someone who is very logical and rational and not giving any importance to emotions, because bottom of the deck, like I said, there is Justice card. Below that you have the high priestess. So it can be that there is some sort of separation that is here, and you are trying to decide, you are not able to make a decision about this separation. Should you separate yourself from this situation or this person, or what is the right thing to do? Basically, you are wondering what is the right thing to do. But like I said, because the High Priestess is beneath that, you can trust your intuition, Gemini. It could be related to something family, like if it's a family issue, and there is a choice definitely to be made, and basically someone just basically wants to move on, move on to a harmonious place. They want a easy flow of emotions, lot of talks. They want to release something, and I'm getting that this person wants to liberate themselves, and they want they don't want anything karmic, or they want things to be balanced. They don't want to do anything they want to be justified basically in whatever that they are doing. So but I'm getting here is that someone is very stubborn here, very narrow-minded. They are immature in a way how they are dealing with things right now. So yes, what are the further messages for the sign of Gemini? You have two cards coming out, Wisdom and Mysticism. Okay, so Wisdom and Mysticism is telling me that you want to make a wise decision regarding whatever decision that is you are not able to make right now. So whatever decision you are making, you are thinking about a best decision. You don't want to make a flawed decision or a skewed decision. You want to, that's why you are probably looking for answers or guidance in something mystical like tarot reading or astrological things. So that's the message that I'm getting there. You are relying on guidance from your intuition, or something that is secret, or that's like occult sciences basically. Give me answer and guidance for Gemini. Answers and guidance for Gemini. How to make this decision? What's the best decision to make here for Gemini Sun Moon Rising November 2018? The perfection of your life. Now, like I was saying, you want to make a perfect decision, like a unbiased decision, like a most apt decision. You want to take that decision and restore and replenish is the bottom of the deck here. So either someone is healing here, or you need to focus on your healing as well. So the perfection of your life. So imagine something that is perfect for you. What's the ideal for you? What's what will soothe your soul, and what will make you feel energized? Do that. Okay, whatever makes you feel completely in resonance with your soul, do that. Luck. So there is a lot of luck factor in whatever that you are deciding, and if you have a clear direction where you are going, you will achieve something that you want. When you will summon all your energies in that one particular direction, it will bring you good luck. So whatever that you are deciding right now, try to be very focused and be clear about your decision and direction that you are heading in, and be confident. So that was your reading, Gemini, for the month of November. I'll see you next month, guys. I hope this resonated with whoever it did, and if you can drop me a comment, it would be really, really nice, and I'll see you again.